You know, Sandra and I often get asked how we got into the sewing and the teaching. And for myself, I learned the basics of it from my mother. I'm the second youngest out of 10 children. I have five brothers and four sisters. And so that's where I learned the basis of threading machine, laying out patterns was with my mom. She sewed for the necessity of it. It wasn't a luxury thing back then. And from there, after graduating from high school in 86, I went to cooking school. And I always enjoyed sewing. I actually took home ec in high school. And the thing is that I could never afford the clothes that I wanted, so I started making my own. And then from there, let's see, I actually started a small business where I did custom sewing and design. And it just progressed into a business that I was able to do that part-time and work in the restaurant part-time. And then I got another job working evenings and weekends. I love to work. I guess I'm considered a workaholic a little bit. But I actually got another job working in a fabric store, and that taught me a lot to work with different types of fabrics and stuff. And then it happened to be that with working at the fabric store, a bunch of the ladies were going to a sewing show in Edmonton. And they wanted to know if I'd want to go along. And I thought, well, this should be a neat thing to see because this was the first time I've ever been at a sewing show. And when we attended the show, this man came up to me, wanted to know where I got my shirt. And I says, well, actually, I made it. And he says, well, are you here with the show? I says, well, I'm actually taking some workshops. And he says, you know, you got to come show that shirt to my wife. And I didn't know who he was, and I didn't know who his wife was. But here was Dan Webster, which is Sandra's husband. So after taking a few classes, I went back to Sandra's booth, and she saw the shirt, and she absolutely loved it. And she ordered two shirts for Dan. So that was how I met Sandra. You know, this is one of those careers that you never plan on doing, and it finds you. And the reason it does is that we have such a passion for it. And if somebody would get up one morning and say, I want to be a sewing teacher, I think stuff like this, it has to come from the heart. And I think that's why it's really, for me, this isn't really a job. It's a career and it's a passion. And I'm very fortunate to work with the best person in the industry. And you know, this is what power sewing is all based on, is the love and the passion of it. If I was asked 20 years ago what I would be doing today, I would have never guessed, honestly. I would have never guessed. But if I was asked to do it all over again, would I change anything? No, not one thing. Not one thing. Yeah.